Just watched a video called PS5 vs. Xbox Series X Free Graphics Upgrades Explained on the channel Gamer X. I don't exactly know how you pronounce that, but I'll leave a link to it down below. This is very informative, and I tell you, there's something I'm really going to like about next gen. I'm probably going to get a Series X, and there's a couple different reasons. I'm probably going to, you know, continue being in the Xbox ecosystem. Probably a couple reasons, and this is one reason. Smart delivery. Xbox has told developers that they cannot charge players to upgrade their current-gen games to Xbox Series X versions as DLC as an alternate to its free smart delivery scheme. I'm liking smart delivery. The concept of smart delivery, and PS5 has a version also highlighted in this video, but it's not as easy as smart delivery. Meaning, let's say you buy Halo Infinite on the Xbox, the current Xbox. Well, you don't have to worry if you buy it on current gen and you get a next gen console. That will instantly be upgraded. Meaning, you don't have to worry, basically. And that's for all their first party games, whether it's, you know, Halo, Gears, Forza, you don't have to worry because through smart delivery, those games will basically adjust to the console that you're playing them on and give you the full power of whatever console you're playing it on. Very nice, very nice. It's a little bit trickier on the PlayStation 5, and it's confusing what's going on with Miles Morales. I think if you buy Miles Morales on the PS4, you get a free graphics upgrade on the PS5, but it's not the same case for the PS4 version of Spider-Man or something like that. I'm not exactly sure. So basically, this is a big advantage for Microsoft and smart delivery, because it's very simple. Now, to be honest here, I was a little bit distracted when he showed off gameplay from Ghost of Tsushima. Man, that game looks beautiful. Beautiful. Most specifically, the grass. I have never seen grass like that in a video game. The way the blades of grass just sway back and forth, the lighting on the grass. I'd probably get my ass cut in half if I was playing that game the first 30 or so minutes, because you know when you play a game and you haven't really seen anything visually before and you're walking around in it, maybe it's like puddles of water and you've never experienced like certain visuals. That would be me during the game. Ghost of Tsushima is going to be 60 frames a second. It's going to get the free upgrade, meaning if you got a PlayStation 4 right now and you buy that game, you don't have to worry. You don't have to worry about the bullshit of getting a $60 definitive edition of the game, which is very nice. That is a very pro-consumer move. I like this. I'm going to finish off sharing one comment from Ryan Absdorf. Says, "This is how Sony and Microsoft are stopping Todd Howard from selling us Skyrim again."